Some wire issue. Okay, let's see if we can work around with that. So I'm going to start with the very, very basic, let's say, can we switch off the light? Let's say we are starting off a total new project, for development or maintenance. You're coming up with a blank slate. The very first thing that Kanban talks about is, you start with whatever you're doing, you've been doing existing. So let's say you have a development software maintenance process. So the bug comes in, you have a queue of bug, it goes through analysis, it goes through fixing, it goes through validation, and then customer approval. So what it says is you first try and visualize your process. It could be in a physical board, it could be in a virtual board, whichever way you're comfortable. You try and visualize that process. So the first capability that we allow, and a lot of Kanban principles that you would see in our products with Kanban. As a quick introduction before we go, we are a company called Digite. We build products for managing the entire application lifecycle, which includes any sort of a methodology, be it waterfall, iterative, RUP. We have a major leading product called Digite Enterprise, which is used by a lot of bigger IT organizations in India. Swift Kanban is a new product which we are very focused on Lean and Kanban because we see that this is going to be the next wave of software development. A lot of companies are now trying more and more flexible and agile ways of working, and Kanban is not limited just to software. A lot of non-software development companies are also trying Kanban. For example, we know of a bunch of HR folks who use Kanban board to visualize their processes and manage the work. So sort of a Kanban has a much more larger universal appeal, and that is where it is gaining traction. This is a product Swift Kanban. So what I've just landed up is I just created a new blank board. Let's say you're starting off and you're trying to visualize your value stream. One of the capability we'd give you is you could go as complex in your value stream it could be, because a lot of teams have multiple team dependencies. So you could actually, you have to visualize the entire process, including multiple teams in a single way. So we give you a lot of capability to define your board. The very first thing that you can do is, it's as simple, you can build the whole damn thing. Let's say you want to have a process which is in between, so you will say analysis. We have a new platform that we've actually launched, SifSync. Using that, we have an integration with 10-15 different tools, so you can actually integrate. TFS is one of them, Jira, Bugzilla, all those tools you can go and integrate. So tickets from flow in from there and move, and then you take this workflow. Okay, so basically you can build, for example, I just added a stage, you could split a stage and, let's say in multiple way, horizontal way, you can move a lane up, you could build a whole really complex workflow that you would like a ticket to take. But once you've done that, your first part is done. I'm not going to save this, I'll just come back. The next thing that you ideally would, identify or build in the system is what are the type of work that you work with. You work with hot fixes, service patches, tickets, user story. So you define your own type of work that you do. So we allow you a capability which you can go and define your type of cards that you do. Each card is, so typically Kanban, the way you would work with a physical board, you will put up a board and you will put stickies. So cards are nothing but stickies, or they classify the work of card type of work we do. So you can color code them, define your own stuff that you would like to work with. And once you're done, let's come back. We'll come back to those. So now the work can flow in. It's very, very simple to use, and you'll see everything that I want to do, I will do it from this interface. I have a new bug that someone will go and add. So I could fill in a description, a whole bunch of parameter. There's a priority classification. You can sort of classify it into various ways. If you're working with user story, you can rank order them. If you want, you can estimate them in points or hours or whichever way you would like. And if there is a due date associated, you can go and put a due date. Now each board, you can build, for each board, you can define a team, who's going to have access to the board, who's going to work, you can define your team. I'm not going to give the admin details, but you can define that in an enterprise where you have multiple boards and multiple different teams are working on it. Each team has only access to their own board that they look up to. The work will go in, anyone, let's say you have a whole pipeline, anyone can simply, take this up. And move this card across. So once the card has gone through the entire workflow and it sits in the last lane, you know, that is sort of indicates the completion of work. So you can go and archive it. Now, there are various simple metrics that Kanban captures. One is obviously you would like to capture how long typically it's taking me from point A, you know, when a customer gives a bug or raises a bug, till when what is actually delivered to the customer, how long typically it takes. So that is called as you know, lead time or a cycle time, you know, as you would refer. So we'll let you capture the entire metric in a real time. So at any point of time you want to figure out, you know, what has happened to the ticket, you will be able to, you know it. I'm just going to move to an existing board that I have set up, you know, to display some of the features. Sure, you could do that if you would like. You know, there are a bunch of capabilities. I'm going to come one by one. So what you see is a board. There are a whole bunch of cards that are there. There are a couple of yellow stickies which are showing that you are working on user stories of issues. There are pink cards which are, you know, saying bugs. You see something in red. So one of the things Kanban again says is that you have to limit your work in progress. You've been hearing a WIP limit, you know, from all these you know, speakers that have been talking about. The whole key principle is that if you take up too many cards at a time, ultimately you're going to lose productivity, quality, you know. Therefore, each ticket you have to focus on it, and you can set limits that, you know, let's say I have two developers or, you know, two support persons. So at max they can only work on two tickets or four tickets at a time, and you put this limit. So if anyone has pulled too many tickets, you'll immediately get a red flag that, you know, something is wrong. So the team is, you know, taking up too much, you know, on their plate, and they will not be able to do it in a, you know, good quality way. So we highlight that in a lot of visual indicators. You've been working on a card, there is some issue that you got stuck, you need some help, you can go and block a card. So there's a feature where you just go and you put an icon, you know, once you just hover on it, it'll show you that, you know, block a card. You can block it with a reason and, you know, say, I mean, I have insufficient information to do it or XYZ. Anyone in the team will be able to see it's on hold, needs some more input. You know, there is a notification built in, so everyone in the team will get notified that something is get stuck, why don't you come over and help me. So therefore, this is also one of the same Kanban principle that identify a bottleneck and try and put together, you know, as a team and work to resolve that bottleneck. So some of these principles, I'll keep talking. Now once you're going through, you know, work, there are a couple of things that people would do. Now if I'm working on a user story, I will probably like to split my, you know, story into subtasks. You know, so that I can at least assign, you know, different people who would work on that. One people can work on same card, or there are multiple people can, you know, can be assigned on this. I'm going to show a quick task. So if you hover on, you know, this, you'll see that you can go and define, you know, sort of tasks for each card. Okay, and once you're going through it, you can indicate the progress, you know, that sort of you will, you know, whether you're done, not done. Also, you can go in, you know, repair, you know, put, let's say, if you have, so some of these are very, very configurable. You've done through plugins. There are some teams who want to track time, there are some teams who don't want to track time. So this is configurable, you can disable time tracking. But you can go and actually report actual hours or remaining hours as you would. The remaining hours is also used for burn down charts, so that we generate. So even Scrum teams can use the tool and work with it. Okay. Now, once you've defined whole set of tasks, there are a couple of other things that you would like to do. If you'd like to find out this ticket with that someone has been working, or who has, you want to come as a manager in a daily stand-up and want to find out who's working on what, right? So you could come and filter the entire board. This, you could have 100 team members, but you as a manager can come over and say, you know what, I'm going to see what is team member one working on and put this filter. So you'll know that right now there are no cards assigned to him. There is something that is planned, he could go and pick up. There is something that he's finished, but right now he's not working on, you know, some of those. So there are a whole bunch of filters that you can do. So a lot of large team, you know, 200 people team also who use one board, and they still very easily are able to manage the way around and figure out what to do what. So you can filter on priority, you can filter on type. You could come over and say, you know, just show me all the critical bugs. So the manager can just focus on, you know, those things. There are some special, you know, things that we build. You can always as a team come over and say, you know what are the things that we have to finish today or this week. So you can filter on those and just focus and talk about, you know, only those cards. Similarly, by release, by iteration, if you've been working on multiple release, you could go and filter, you know, based on that. I'm just gonna go and reset. Okay, so I have a whole bunch of bugs. Now, one of the other things that you know you could do is if you want to find out more detail, there are some cool things that we built. You can just scroll over it. You don't have to go anywhere. So you'll notice that I've not gone beyond this board to see anything else as of now. There are a couple of features which are behind the door, but you know, as of now, you could manage your work from one single board. A lot of teams have also put touch screens in their bay, so they could just display this Kanban board and just come and swipe the card. So it is supported on touch devices, including iPad or any of these. So they could just go, if there's one team board, they could just swipe and say, I'm done. So typically a lot of stand-ups also happen on a board where people can just hurl up and say, you know what, I'm done. They can just move it and you know, mark it done. There are a whole couple of other features you know, which we show. Let me just show one quick thing. If you come over and you want to find out how long this card has been in progress, you could go and flip this card and it will show you the entire log. How, you know, when was it, you know, added to the, let me just get a detailed view. So it could tell you that this card was raised or this ticket was raised by a customer, you know, on so and so date. It was sitting there for, let's say, 10 hours. Then it moved to ready where it waited for 21 hours. Then, you know, it went in progress or someone jumped the queue directly and said, you know, this is done, X, Y, Z. So the entire detailed metric for your value stream, you'll get it right here. So at any point of time, you'll know how long something has been in progress, something is, you know, not been working. There's also, for a lot of Scrum teams, you would find this interesting that you could take up a bigger card and slice it into various smaller, you know, hierarchical, so you can build a whole decomposition right here. So if you've attended Jeff Payton's story mapping session, so you could actually take a big, you know, epic, or if you work with big features, you can break it down into multiple ways and get a visual hierarchy of, you know, what is, you know, how much things are complete. So you could see you have 25% of this epic done, whereas it has a whole bunch of stories. You know, and child cards. Now, these could also, if you're working with multiple boards, so there are times when you have three teams working on a release, you could have three different boards at each of your team level. You have independent team members, but there are some interdependency that you want to manage. So you can, you know, build a system here where you can have one big card and smaller cards in different boards. You'll still get the roll up and you know, you'll figure out that, you know, how are things working. You build your own structure. We are not putting any structure, you define. If you can have 10 level structure, you can have 3 level structure, you define your own thing. You know, and even the labels, we are not restricting. We don't say, you know, you call epic. Some call epic, some call theme, some call, you know, a big feature, you know, anything you want to call, you call it. Okay, I'm just going to go quickly. I think we are almost done with the time. Absolutely, you can. If you've noticed that when I've added a card, you know, I have an option to choose the backlog, or I can just choose to just push it on the board. So I have also my backlog, which I can go to. You know, absolutely, you can go and do a planning. You have a backlog where you have all the list of backlog items. You can go do filtering and, you know, let's say do some smart filtering, show me all the cards which are ranked greater than 9, and it'll go and search and get you immediately. You could also do a bit of release planning, and we have taken a little different approach for releases. You could, once you go and you know, you have to do a release planning. Let me show a different board. So this is another configuration of a board where you have a sprint backlog which you can line up. You have, you know, prioritization, execution, and you know, then done. So each team can build their own you know, sort of lanes and sub lanes and stuff. So there's one feature which I can show you. It's a release planning. When you can go simply select your scope, once you edit it, this will show you the entire backlog, and you can go and push and put things into the release, and based on the capacity of the release, it will go start filling up. The capacity will start filling up, and you know, as you start, you know, doing the cards, the progress indicator will also show up. So right in the interface, you can do release planning. From this, you can even break it down and do a sprint planning, but these are all configurable. You choose the level of you know, Scrum adoption you are doing or Kanban adoption you're doing, and
work with it.
Yeah, absolutely. So the progress is actually based on the board. So you're just, this is a planning view where you're just putting the scope.
On this planning, I can just drag this card from here and put it on the dashboard?
So here you do a plan, and then you can go to the board and pull from the release backlog and put it on the board. So that is sort of, absolutely. And once you're, you know, sort of done the planning, you start executing. If some of you will report remaining hours on task, and based on that, you can even get a burn down chart right here. Yeah, absolutely. So these are iterations, and then you can go and pick up a chart and show you a burn down chart. So both burn down, burn up, if you've been, you know, capturing effort that way. I'm just going to come some of the Kanban metrics. So we support a lot of, we give a lot of you know, default Kanban metrics. One of the key metrics, which is similar to let's say a burn down in Scrum, is sort of cumulative flow diagram. So basically you track in all possibility you should have an even line, but if you see there are too many spikes in between a lane, that is where your capacity is not up to the mark. There are some things which are getting piled up in dev lane or, you know, so a lot of predictions can be done. You can even filter this board based on, you know, a lot of type of card, select lane, unselect lane. You can also track lead time, cycle time, as I was saying. A lot of team, one of the things that you will see is that you don't have to work on any of these metrics. As you're working it, we are capturing time at each stage of your workflow, and based on that we can tell you the, you know, average time a typical card took, and you can even slice it and say, you know what, show me average time that a user story has taken or user story of size Excel took. You know, based on that you can get a whole bunch of metric put in. We also support a lot of control charts, so you can get a control chart which can say based on the 3 sigma limit how many cards have exceeded, gone beyond, you know, the cycle time beyond 3 sigma limit, and, you know, not. And a bunch of other charts. I mean, I'm not going to go into too detail. And just quickly switch back. This also has feature a lot of other notifications and inbox. So each team member can come and see his inbox, what are the cards he has signed up for, and, you know, is due to deliver. There are dashboards that you can see for various ways. Each guy can come and personalize his dashboards. One other thing that I'm going to show, something we are working on, and any questions on this so far? Anything specific that you guys are looking for? So in a way, it covers the entire Kanban workflow, and it's fairly, fairly simple. You can adopt it anything. We have seen people using personal Kanban. It's a big wave wherein, you know, to-do is something which is a little old way because you have a whole bunch, and, you know, a lot of time you'll keep looking at the to-do and not do. So it says that, you know, that is what multitasking sort of becomes. And Kanban says if you just simply say, you know, this is my to-do, this is in progress done, and pick up one thing at a time, the chances of finishing that are much higher than actually when you keep looking at your backlog. So a lot of people use personal Kanban. There are books on personal Kanban. Jim Benson, one of the thought leader, is working on personal Kanban. So he spearheads a lot of this personal Kanban. We have seen in schools, at least not here in US, they use Kanban board and, you know, put the whole homework for kids and say, you know what, this is your list of homework that you got to do. And, you know, they, as they do it, they finish up. So the whole feel of moving a card also, you know, is sort of a lot of big productivity booster. So every time they go and move a card, they say, you know, I'm done. And so it'll let you slice in a small way or ticket, which otherwise just to update status in some tool is boring. So it's sort of, it's a different way, you know, that is picking up. Apart from this, I'm just going to show you one thing that we're working on. It is more of a sort of, still in progress, but we thought in this demo we can probably show. We're working on a whole simulation model wherein we could simulate, if you given this is your backlog, this is the speed of your delivery, how long will it take to finish off your entire backlog? Okay. So for example, I'm just going to show you that I have, let's say, 3 resources. I have 1 developer, 1 designer, 1 tester, and let's say I have 30 user story. I could run this simulation, and it'll actually take, and I already show you there was a lane that you can go and set up. Just give me a minute. It'll actually simulate how the things will go and pile up. It'll show you the burn down chart right live, how the whole project will go for, let's say, 6 months from now, and tell you that it'll take you 1763 days to be able to finish at the current pace you're doing. So then you can go and now plan a little more and say, you know what, let me try adding 3 more developers. Because if you see here, if you had noticed, you know, the coding lane was getting choked because we had just 1 developer. He's taking a lot longer than the tester to fix, but the tester is sitting most of the time idle. So there was a utilization charge that we were showing. Now we're going to go change it, and I say, you know what, I will put in 12 developers and save it. And I could come and again run the simulation. So it is telling me now from 1763 days, you can finish this whole thing in 241 days if you have 12 developers. So you can define your optimum size, figure out using some of this simulation, and it'll help you to predict you know, a lot better than, you know, what you do. There's a whole lot of capability that we're building in this. We are saying you could also say, you know, things are not ideal. You will have user stories, but once you're going through, you'll get bugs. So you, for any lane, you know, I could go and say, you know what, I can Okay, I can go and define, saying that I have a primary resource which is developer, but as soon as a tester gets free, we usually go and put him on testing. So you can even simulate that scenario and go. There are a couple of scenarios that you can model that saying there are 50% probability that bugs will get injected once tester is tested it. So it could even simulate and say, you know what, once 30 stories are done, let's inject some bugs for 50% of the time and then simulate and then tell you the real time. So this is something we are working on with a lot of early customers. So I just thought to show. So we are trying to build a lot of other scenarios. If you guys have any difficult scenario in mind, you know, drop us an email. We'll be happy to solve that. Yeah. All right, that is what we have to show. Any questions? You guys joined late. I mean, are you guys doing Kanban? Scrum. Oh, okay. Same company? Okay. Which company is it?
Tesco.
Tesco. Oh, okay. Okay. Absolutely. So if you go online, swiftkanban.com, there's a free trial sign up. It's on the web. You don't need to ask anyone. It'll just go. You can get started for 30 days. If you need extension. No, this is not there. This is still, we are working on it. We can look at that. That's a separate piece. We have to see how we enable it for you. Jira demo is available immediately. TFS works with a whole integration plugin manager that we have built. So we're still trying to put things. So, but we can run it for a pilot for sure. Any other questions? All right. Thank you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you
for your time.